Hello everyone, welcome to online class. Today I am going to explain you a social lesson of 6th standard. So lesson name is National Symbols and National Integration. So this is the second chapter of civics. So in this lesson we are coming across about national symbols, national anthem, national animal and bird, meaning of national integration, diversity and also unity in diversity. So these are all the important points we are going to see in this lesson today. What are national symbols, children? What are the national symbols of our country? Do you know? Forgotten, I think. No, let me see. Generally a country uses the symbols which reflects its culture and heritage. So a country will be having symbols which reflects country's culture and heritage. They are called national symbols. Most importantly, the national flag and national emblem are the national symbols. Do you remember about the national flag and national emblem? Yeah, tricolor flag is the national flag. Tricolor flag is our national flag. And national emblem is four-headed lion. Every nation has its own national anthem. So similarly, how we are having our national anthem and national flag, every country will be having its own national anthem. Similarly, India has also its national animal and national bird. Tiger is the national animal and peacock is our national bird. These are useful in creating patriotism and national integrity among the citizen. When all these features will be there in one country, automatically the citizens will get patriotism towards their country. Let me see about our national anthem. Do you remember which is our national anthem? Who written it? Jana Gana Mana is our national anthem, and Rabindranath Tagore has been written it, isn't it? Jana Gana Mana is our national anthem. It was written in 1919. So which year it was written? 1911 by Rabindranath Tagore. In which language it was written? It was written in Bengali language. Out of the 5 stanzas, totally this song is having 5 stanzas. The first stanza was adapted as our national anthem by the Constituent Assembly on 24th January 1950. So our national anthem is by Rabindranath Tagore. It contains 5 stanzas. Among them, only first stanza has taken as a national anthem. So it was adopted on 24th January 1950 by our Constituent Assembly. It requires 52 seconds to sing a national anthem. However, you want, you cannot sing that. To complete, means to sing the national anthem, it will take correctly 52 seconds. That is the correct measure to sing the national anthem. On some occasions, the first and the last lines only are sung, and it requires only 20 seconds. Only some special occasions will be there. That time, only first and last line will be sung. So the time required for it is only 20 seconds. It is the duty of every Indian to respect the national anthem. All of us know in school also, when national anthem is singing, how you'll stand in attention, isn't it? And it shows the giving respect to our national anthem. Showing disrespect and hindering its singing are considered as considerable offense under the law. So however you want, means pronunciation also must be clear. while singing it. And showing disrespect for the national anthem is considered as an offense under the law. You may be punished for that. So how we must respect it? Standing erect in discipline while singing the national anthem. Always when you hear the national anthem, you must stand in a erect. Erect means in attention. Singing with flawful pronunciation. So pronunciation must be correct. This is about our national anthem. Let we go next for the national flag. National flag. The flag is the emblem of a nation. It is the proof of freedom, patriotism, unity and allegiance of the nation. And every citizen is moved heartily when the flag is raised on the pole. So whenever you raise the flag will be hoisted in your school, do you remember? Two main important day will be there. One is Independence Day and another one is Republic Day. Isn't it? How will you stand on that time? By saluting it and showing respect, isn't it? So by seeing our national flag only, one will get the patriotism, unity and allegiance to the nation. And every citizen move heartily when the flag is raised to the pole. Whenever you will raise or hoist the flag, it must be raised up to the top of the pole, not half of the pole. So now let we go detail for the tricolor national flag of India. Our flag comprises of three colors. All of us know, isn't it? Saffron at the top, white at the center and green at the bottom. At the center of the white color, there is a blue color veil. So the center of the white color, blue color veil will be there. The wheel contains 24 spokes. Spokes means lines will be there. As your cycle tire will be having spokes, same like that, 24 spokes will be there in this blue color circle or a wheel. The radius of the wheel fits is same as the white color part. So the radius of the white wheel will be fit in the white color. The flag has a rectangular shape. The shape of the flag will be rectangular. Its length and breadth are in the ratio of 3:2. So at what ratio the flag will be? 3:2. The three color stripes are in equal proportion. All three color means saffron, white and green will be at the same proportion. The cloth of the flag can be either cotton or silk. So which type of cloth we can use for the flag? Only cotton or a silk cloth. In addition, it should be handed woven. In addition what? It should be woven by a hand, not by a machine. Its thread should be have been hand spun. Only by the hand spun the flag cloth must be prepared. Now let me see uniqueness of a national flag. What do the colors of the flag indicates? While the saffron represents selflessness and sacrifice. So the saffron color, the top color of the flag, represents selflessness and sacrifice. White color indicates truth, peace and purity. So white color is indicating truth, peace and purity. Green is the symbol of faith, fertility and prosperity. Same like that. Green color symbol that faith, fertility and prosperity of the country. It is the symbol of abundant agriculture and industry. So fertility and prosperity is nothing but showing the abundant agriculture and industry of our country. The wheel is the reflection of the wheel engraved in Ashoka pillar of Saranath. So in white color, I already had told, the blue color wheel will be there. It is nothing but the Ashoka pillar. It is taken by the Ashoka pillar of Saranath. The wheel of Ashoka is also the image of constant movement and progress. Now let me see what all the rules of national flag. Some of the rules are there for hoisting of the national flag. The flag should not be dirty or torn. We must always see that whenever we hoist the flag, it must be clean, and it must be clean cloth, and it must be torn. And while hoisting, the saffron color should be displayed at the top, and should not hoist any other flag to the height of the national flag. Always the national flag must be in the top, and down of that any other flag we can hoist. Should be raised till the tip of the pole and hoisted. Whenever you hoist the flag, it should be up to the tip of the, means to the top of the pole. Always flag should be hoisted after sunrise, and remove the flag before sunset and keep it folded. So whenever you will hoist the flag before after sunrise, when the sun will rise, at that time you must hoist the flag, and before the sunset only you must get it down, and you must fold and keep it inside. Should hoist the flag of half of its height during national mourning. Mourning means whenever the important person will die, to show respect for them, the national flag must be hoisted to the half of the height of the pole. Only at that time the flag can hoist up to the half of the pole. While walking, the flag to be held in right hand. Or while walking, you want to hold the flag, means always you must hold the flag in your right hand. The flag should not touch the ground at any moment. That is very, very important. You must not touch the flag to the ground. And plastic flag should not be used. That is very important. Nowadays all of you will bring the plastic flags, isn't it, during the Independence Day and Republic Day. That is very wrong. You must not use the plastic flags. This is about our national flag. Next, let me see our national emblem. Observe our national emblem once. It is the true version of the base portion of the Ashoka pillar at Saranath. So the emblem, the four-headed lion is there, see, that has been taken by the base part of the pillar, which is the Ashoka pillar at Saranath. From that it has been taken. At its base, as lions are there, this is called the lion base. So at the base, you can see here, the lions are there. Four lions will be there. One we cannot see, only three we can see here. So it has said has four, the lion base. The lion base of Saranath is our national emblem or imprint. In the original sculpture, four lions are standing on a platform facing four directions. So they are facing four directions: north, east, west, and south. Its back facing each other. The base is round in shape. There is a wheel in all the four directions. So in this also you can see wheel is there in the middle. So same like that, in the four direction also we can see the wheel. And there is a wheel in all four directions. Between the wheels there are images of elephant, bull, horse and lion. So four wheels are there in between them. What all the animals we can see? Elephant, bull, horse and lions also are there. The wheel at the base is known as the wheel of Dharma. So this wheel is there, no? That is said as the wheel of Dharma. Even on the white stripe of the flag, the symbol of the wheel is found. So what the blue color wheel we have taken in our flag, that is the same wheel, the wheel of Dharma. The government of India adopted our national emblem on 26 January 1950 on Republic Day. In the picture, only three lions are seen. A Devanagari line called Satyameva Jayate, truth alone prevails, taken from the Mundaka Upanishad, is found at the bottom of the base. So when was our national emblem was adopted? On 26th January 1950. And the picture of the three lions are being seen, and a Devanagari line is there down of that sculpture. इट इज रिटन एज सत्यमेव जयते. सत्यमेव जयते इट इज सांस्कृत. सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट मीन्स ट्रूथ अलोन प्रिवेल्स. एंड टेकन दिस लाइन हैज बीन टेकन फ्रॉम मुंडक उपनिषद इज फाउंड एट द बॉटम ऑफ द बेस. सो दिस इज अबाउट द नेशनल एम्ब्लम. नेक्स्ट नेशनल एनिमल एंड नेशनल बर्ड. I think you are familiar about our national animal and bird, isn't it? Tiger and peacock. The tiger is our national animal and it is active. Its physique is strong. The peacock is our national bird. Its feathers at the top of its head look like a cap, which is attractive to see. So peacock is very beautiful bird. All of us know that is our national bird. Next, let me go for the meaning of national integration. National integration means living harmoniously without having hatred, jealousy, or prejudice against another person or community. Means treating all as equal. Means loving each one as ourselves. It is known as national integration. It means one respecting the other and living in amity. It is the feeling of living as equal members in the family of nation. National integration refers to that situation where all people of the country feel they are one, although there are differences with regard to race, religion, culture, and language. Even though many of types of people or many caste, religion, culture, language will be different, but we are living together in one country, isn't it? So we must live as a family members. That is nothing but the showing the integration. It is necessary to create such feeling among all for building a strong nation. So whenever no conflicts will be there inside of the country, at that time what happens, anyone can build a strong nation. The national integration is one which strengthens the feeling of equality among all the people. When national integration will be there, what happens? Automatically it will strengthen the feeling of equality among all the citizens of the country. Now, why national integration is important? The national integration is necessary to create unity among the people. Suppose inside the country only, one together gone fighting means there will be peace in the country? No. So, it is very necessary to create a unity among the people. It is also necessary to create the feeling of oneness to achieve the self-vested interest and develop the nation. So we must feel that it is our country, then only anything can, means we can develop the nation. National integration prominently encourages in achieving national unity, brotherhood and equality. Means it wherever the national integration will be there, automatically it encourages to achieve national unity, brotherhood and equality. Now let's go to diversity. What is diversity? This is manifested in the natural diversity, biodiversity and diversity in life of the people. So, natural, let me see what is meant by natural diversity. India contains high mountains, very long rivers and large plains. In the same way, there are regions with severe cold and high temperature. There are hard deserts here, and the nature has blessed us with a dense forest, cool and fresh lakes, waterfalls, attractive beaches, and hundreds of small islands. So this is said as natural diversity. So if you go through whole India, all places will be remain not similar. In the some place we can see some of the significant, isn't it? Same like that, we are having the high mountains and deserts are there, and some places are severe cold are there, some places are with high temperature, and dense forests we can see, and cool and fresh lakes we are having, waterfalls we can see, and attractive beaches will be there, and hundreds of small islands also are there. This is said as natural diversity. So it refers to all the variety of life that can be found on earth: plants, animals, fungi and microorganisms. Now let me see what is biodiversity. The biodiversity is huge. Only a few nations in the world have such biodiversity. Means biodiversity means we here we can say about the plants and animals. Till now we have identified and described 47,000 groups of plants. In India there are 90,000 species of animal life. It includes 1,232 kinds of birds and 2,546 groups of fishes. An appreciable variety of living organisms is the valuable asset of India. Such a many types of plants, animals, fish, all we can find in our only in our India. Such a biodiversity we are having. Next, population diversity. Population means we people, how many peoples are living in inside the country. People belonging to different communities live in India. There is diversity in appearance, physique, language, food, manner, customs and also religions. It is required to travel throughout India to know the beauty of life of the people. To come across all this means once we must go through whole of our India, we must travel, then only we will come to know how beautiful our India and Indian people are there. Next is unity in diversity. The living culture of community that has faith in different languages, culture and religion is called unity in diversity. So the living culture of community means people that has faith in different languages, culture and religion, that is said as unity in diversity. India is a diverse nation and ranks second in the world in population. So in the population, India stands in second place. First place in East goes to China. Second is our India. Our country has geographical diversity also. And everyone can follow the religion of his choice. No one will object you following your own religion. Choice is yours. They can mix with the social life by way of speaking their own regional languages. So whichever language you want, you can speak. And we can find unity in diversity among different people who live together. So we come to know that the people, if they are having a different community or religion, they are following different race or language, or their community will be different, then also with harmoniously they are all will live in the same country, that is known as unity in diversity. People belonging to multicultural who have faith in different language, culture and religion live in India. We find unity in diversity among the people who lead a variety of life. Our constitution has recognized the diversity. Diversity is the strength of India and never a weakness. Even though we are having a diversity of people or anything, it is not a weakness of our country. It is a strength of our country. I think you have understood the lesson. So in this lesson, what all we come to know? The national symbols, national anthem, national flag, national animal and bird, meaning of national integration, diversity, unity and diversity. So once again you refer the textbook for further and go on studying. Thank you.